Are you new to Siege and you want to learn what every single operator does? Cool. Are you, or maybe a veteran to Siege and you want to know what every single operator does? Why? There's only 57 of them, and you should know by now if you're a veteran. Who cares? There's 5 minutes in this video, and I'm gonna go as fast as I can before that timer runs out. So, here we go. Sledge likes taking out his big old hammer, and he likes thwonking holes in walls. Mute uses Wi-Fi routers to jam any electronics, including drones. Thatcher throws glorified Pokeballs at defender equipment in order to disable them, just like Mute does. Smoke makes it really hard to breathe for attackers and defenders alike, except for himself. Don't ask him what's inside of the canister. Thermite makes really big fucking holes inside of walls, and also people, depending how close you're standing next to them when they explode. Castle can make it really hard for people to enter the building through windows and doors, except he can be countered by almost 14 people. Twitch has 2 shock drones, which she uses to send cameras and defender equipment into the Shadow Realm. Monty is a living shield that absorbs more damage than a boat in a Phil Swift commercial, except for when he gets tackled by orcs and gets bodied. Pulse can see your still beating heart through walls and will vibe check you if you stay in one place for too long. Glaz can see through smoke, and you cannot see through smoke, and he can see through smoke. Some say Doc's operator ability is to heal. No, it's actually to spawn peek the enemy team unrelentlessly. Fuse helps accelerate the unalive process by turning defenders into bits of shrapnel and meat. Rook sets down armor plates knitted with love that'll help buff anybody that picks them up. Blitz has flashbang strapped to the front of his riot shield and can turn your senses into the senses of Helen Keller within a matter of seconds. Capkin puts explosive traps in door frames and windows that increases the demand for wheelchairs ever so slightly. Anything that has an electronic pulse IQ can pick up and see through walls. Buck likes to fuck anything within 3 meters of him because he has a shotgun strapped to the bottom of his rifles.
Kachaka is our one true lord and savior and needs no introduction.
Blackbeard has glorified saran wrap strapped to the both of his guns, which do absolutely nothing compared to what they used to do before. Frost puts down bear traps, which gives her a PhD in breaking ankles whenever she feels like it. Capitao takes the terms, "I'm going to flame and smoke you," way too literally. Valkyrie puts down special cameras that she allows the normies on her team to use. Ana is like Thermite, but her operator ability is more suited for hatches instead of breaching walls. Echo is one of the most annoying operators in the game, and good luck playing him in ranked. Jackal, much like Echo, will be banned 90% of the time because he has a weird foot fetish that nobody likes to deal with. Mira can see you, but you can't see her, but Mira can see you, but you can't see her. Ying induces fear and epilepsy in those close enough to see your party ball's flashes. Ella makes the whole aiming ordeal really hard for anybody close enough to get hit by one of her grenades. If Ash is your girlfriend, Zofia is the girl that you tell her not to worry about. Jaeger absorbs over half of the attacking team's throwables and has one of the best rifles in the game. Bandit's main job is to prevent hard breachers from doing their thing. Dokubi cares for you and calls you every now and then just to check on your well-being. Legion throws down spikes that poison your toes over time. Vigil's camera shine cannot be seen by drones when he feels like it. Lion can see the approximate location of anybody that feels like moving when his ability is active. Asher uses his bulletproof cameras to tase attackers like somebody who's resisting arrest from a police officer. Finka uses dormant robots inside of her bloodstream to achieve zero recoil and buff all of her team. Just because you are shooting Alibi does not actually mean you may be shooting at her sometimes. Maverick can make dozens of glory holes inside of reinforced walls to shoot attackers from the outside in. Clash is like Monty, only difference being she violently shocks anyone that she deems a Muppet. Kane, much like Bandit, can electrify almost anything that is made of metal. Nomad uses air jabs to knock the wind out of any defenders that think they're good at roaming. Mozzie uses 3 little scary spiders to capture attacking drones to use them for himself. Warden's existence and usefulness solely depends on if Glaz or Ying is on the enemy team. Goyo has bombs strapped to the back of deployable shields that hurt attackers and defenders alike. Gridlock is the operator equivalent of making defenders step on Legos.
And she is the definition of cake.
Wumai is like the great value Raisin Bran version of Jaeger. Amaru's ability is to any percent glitchless speed run towards the objective. Kelly is the operator you use if Thatcher is banned and you need to get rid of gadgets. Lucy's operator ability is to make attackers walk all slow-like. Ayana is a glorified drone that could basically make a clone of herself. Ace is the product of what happens if Thermite and Hibana fucked without a condom. Orcs is absolutely without a doubt the Kool-Aid Man of Rainbow Six Siege.
Oh yeah!
And finally, Zero is the botched version of Sam Fisher that Ubisoft decided to put into the game and he shoots cameras into walls.
45 seconds left. Oh man. Alright, well, I guess that's all operators in less than 4 minutes 30 seconds, or 4 minutes 15 seconds, I don't even know. If you enjoyed this video, I'm not gonna tell you how to click your buttons. You're a strong independent viewer who don't need no YouTube-ass bitch YouTuber telling them where to click, okay? I hope you enjoyed my video. Thank you for watching.